Things to think about in this, the beginning of this first full week of 2019. Where is the energy markets going? I had the pleasure over the last few days to speak with some of the world's leading energy policy makers, the OPEC Secretary General, the UAE Energy Minister, the Saudi Minister of Energy, most importantly. And also on the industry side, I had the chance to speak with the global CEO of Siemens and take the temperature of their views for the year ahead. And interestingly, they all were somewhat more optimistic than I would have thought after a rather dramatic quarter four that we just came out of. They all feel that more or less fourth quarter was an overreaction when we saw oil prices collapse by some 40%. We saw stock markets and nearly every other market take a significant hit at the end of last year. And the general sentiment amongst those major oil policymakers was market overreacted. It's going to correct in the first half this year, especially on the back of OPEC's commitment to cut 1.2 million barrels of oil supply out of the market. They believe, the Saudi minister in particular stating, and the UAE, that that will be sufficient to rebalance the supply-demand equilibrium. Essentially, from their target point of view, they said that they will take 40 million barrels off the global oil inventories and bring them back to a five-year average, and that should help prop prices back up towards the $70 barrel. We'll have to see if that works out. We'll have to see if that commitment to remove barrels actually succeeds. The big caveat, of course, as we've seen over recent years, is the shale oil producers are just continuously working away in the background, adding yet more and more capacity, saying, thank you very much, OPEC, for keeping the price nice and high, so we can continue to make lots of money and take your market share. That is the big conundrum in this equation. Will OPEC continue to deliver high enough prices so that high-cost producers can continue to enjoy a lot of profitability? That dilemma goes on, but for now, OPEC are committed to that status through 2019, and we'll see how things play out in the coming weeks and months.